Welcome to NLTV Somanula Awas. Aji NLTV dan ide Kohima de Don Bosco Higher Secondary School de aina ase. Ide aina thai do ami dan dikhe ase ki ta 50 years anniversary to Golden Jubilee to celebrate kora ase aji 20 of November de. Aro ide program de ami dan dikhe ase ki manu bishi aise tan la purna students tan aro teachers lectures ami bishi aise. Aro ami dan idu special guest Sri J Alam IAS, tai Chief Secretary of Government of Nagaland, tai bi aise, ena na amin han dikhe ase, ai bi amin han idum program do sawo.
I take this stand on behalf of all the old students of this school. It's been a great homecoming for us. I've been a student of Catholic schools all my life. Started my early education in a school in Darjeeling in the early 70s and joined this school in the mid 70s. Passed out in 1980, so I am the batch of 1980. This school has probably touched us in the most important years of our life. When we were here, we started off with a very old building on the right of you. It was just a one-storied structure with CGI roofing, just one row of classrooms with a very big corridor and a lot of table tennis tables. And I remember that during recess hours, there was always a mad scramble from all of us to get onto the table as fast as possible. And the ladies always beat us to it. I remember then that when Father Francis and Father Jonas joined us, that time they were not fathers, they were brothers. And that time they didn't have gray hair, they had black hair, which was not really a lot of thick black hair, not balding. They joined us in the late 70s, and they didn't only teach us as teachers, but they also played together with us. And I remember the good times we had with them. When I was a student here, Father Lewis and Father Kuriakos were the principals. They were people who really cared for us, who were kind, who were firm many times, but who were kind and who took a personal interest in all the activities that we had as students to bring us up in the right way. I remember all my teachers, many of them have passed away. Many of them I know are still alive and doing well. I want to take this privilege to thank all my teachers, the principals, Father Francis, Father Jonas, all the teachers who have had such an impact on shaping us and forming our early formative years. Thank you very much. We've just mentioned about Tarsus. I always remember him, always smiling, always available, always helpful. Thank you for all those people who walk behind the scenes to make this school run properly. Starting off with that small one row of classrooms, today we have come a long way. We have massive buildings, not only a school, but a higher secondary school and even a college. And I want to thank God for his faithfulness in all these years in bringing up this school to its present day. The 70s where we studied was really an age of innocence. It was very simple. We had no computers. There was no television. We didn't know what a TV looked like. There were no mobile and smartphones. There was no internet connectivity. And learning was a bit slow. But then we still found ways, and the school still found ways to teach us, not to just educate in academics, but in so many other ways, in teaching us, giving us a wholesome, holistic education. And I thank the school for that. I remember seeing the first magic show in my life in this school, and the fathers had arranged that for us. So the school went a long way, not just in academics, but in many other ways to bring us up right, to bring us up with a wholesome, holistic education. Thank you to the school for that. I was given 5 minutes. I was told that I can speak for 5 minutes. So I just end with a short thought for the students, for the teachers, and for all those of us who are gathered here. For the students, there's a popular Christian chorus which says, "This is the day that the Lord has made. We will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day that God has made for you. You are in your youth, the best times of your life. Enjoy, participate in the school, learn from your friends, learn from your teachers, get the best and most out of your teachers, and make friends. I've made friends here in this school 40 years or 40 plus years back, and these friendships are still going strong, growing from day to day, from strength to strength. It stands you in good stead. I would advise the students to make the best use of the opportunity that this school has to offer. In those times, education was limited to the classrooms and to the interaction. Yes, we didn't have computers and we didn't have the internet, but there was a lot of close connectivity between the teachers and the students. And so nowadays, your scope of educating yourself is much bigger. You can Google anything, you can learn anything, and I hope you make full use of the opportunity that God has given you to be a part of this school. For the teachers, I would just like to say that we as students were brought up not just given academic education, but also given moral guidelines for us to follow. This school has both. It's got, and I wish that the teachers would continue this tradition. Not only bring up your teach history, geography, mathematics, and so on to your students, but also teach them to be good human beings. This is our request to our teachers who are serving now at present in Don Bosco. I'd just like to end with a very short story.
I would first like to congratulate the principal, the staff, the students, the alumni, and all the well-wishers of Don Bosco Higher Secondary School, Kohima, on the celebration of its Golden Jubilee. I also convey my greetings to all the pioneers, the well-wishers, and all those who have had given a helping hand to build this institution and to reach it at this stage where it is today. It's a pleasure to be here with you all on this day, which marks 50 years of existence and service to our people. When my colleague KD Vizo approached me to be part of this program, I readily agreed because I consider it as a great honor to be amongst you all on this joyous occasion. I also thank the organizing committee for according a grand welcome to me. It is actually my first visit to Don Bosco School, and I consider it, maybe it was my bad luck, I would say, that I could never visit this premier institution in Friends, when we come to school education, the immense contribution of Catholic schools cannot be ignored. I was recently going through a report by a World Bank economist, Quintin Waddon. He has written a report, Global Catholic Education 2020, and he has given the facts and figures which I just wanted to share with you to bring home the point that how Catholic education is contributing to humanity. There are more than 220,000 Catholic schools worldwide, and 63 million students are studying in these schools. This economist also calculated as to how much money the governments are saving, because ultimately school education is to be provided by the states, by the governments. But through these schools, $63 billion of saving is accruing to the governments all over the world. $63 billion. That is actually more than the budget of more than 150 countries. So that is the extent to which you are contributing. What is more important is the quality of education in these schools. The quality of education in these schools is much better than many of the government schools and many other private schools. And that is how the service to humanity, the service to the people, can be gauged from the scale at which Catholic schools are serving. Don Bosco fraternity also, I am told, worldwide they are running more than 3,000 institutions. And even in Nagaland, there are 6 schools being run by Don Bosco. I want to compliment the authorities for imparting quality education to thousands of students, irrespective of their caste, creed, color, faith, or religion. In Nagaland, we have 2,706 schools. All together, primary, elementary, secondary, higher secondary, all put together, 2,706. Out of which 62% schools are actually private schools, which includes the schools run by the charities and faith-based organizations. This itself shows that people are actually not after free education. They want quality education. And that is why many parents, they prefer to send their children to private school, even though they have to spend money from their pockets. Of course, the government is aware of these facts, and of late, a lot of efforts are being made to improve the quality of education in government schools also. I am happy to share with you that recently a new World Bank-aided project has been launched to improve the quality of schools in the state. And the idea is to develop lighthouse schools. They will actually work like lighthouses to guide other schools in their vicinities. So this model is being worked out in consultation with the World Bank experts, and a number of schools will be chosen where they will be developed like, you know, the top quality schools in the government sector also. Friends, a school is built not by bricks and mortar, but it is also built by the students and teachers who make it into a thriving institution. A school is often called a temple of education because it has the sacred mission to provide the greatest avenues for fulfillment of the potential of each student and to inculcate right values in her so that they become productive citizens and contribute to the overall development of their communities, societies, nations, and the humanity at large. Above all, education provides happiness to individuals. At this juncture, I am reminded of the philosophy that the founder of Don Bosco fraternity, believed in, and which Don Bosco institutions also have been carrying forward. This has been summed up by Pope Francis in his message to International Office of Catholic Education in 2019, and I quote, "We need to place at the center of the educational action the person in her full integrity. To this end, the educator must be competent, qualified, and at the same time rich in humanity, capable of mingling with the students in order to promote their human and spiritual growth. This is, in short, actually sums up what Don Bosco School has been doing all these years. I am told that the focus of education here is on integral education, and the results is there for everybody to see. I wish to compliment the school management, the teachers and the staff that come here from all parts of the country to nurture this institution over the last 50 years and imparting quality education to thousands of young students. Let me assure you that your contribution, your sacrifices, and your commitment to a noble cause is well recognized by the society, by the people, and the state as a whole. Though we have nothing to give you in return except our deep sense of gratitude. Golden Jubilee is also a time to reflect on where we need to go from here. In the current context, it is also a unique opportunity to introspect, particularly at a time when a new national education policy has come into effect in the country, which aims at a paradigm shift in the way we impart and manage education in India. Friends, teaching and learning is a lifelong process. The teaching fraternity has to play a role of a facilitator, a counselor, a friend, a parent, and many other roles. Our children are growing up in a world filled with complexities, a world that has become increasingly challenging socially, emotionally, and technologically. In today's world, it's not enough to acquire some basic skills to lead life. Technology is moving fast, and in the next decade, it's quite possible that many of the basic functions performed by human beings today will be taken over by machines. Therefore, students have to have the right life skills to survive in the rapidly changing technological world. The onus is on the institutions, especially on the teachers, to prepare their students in a way that they are globally relevant, have the right life skills, and yet are sensitive to the needs of the society they live in. This also implies that the teaching community should not be left behind in the race of time. Just like their learners, the teachers too learn new lessons every single day. A teacher who is introspective and in tandem with the changing scenario will be able to relate better to the needs of the children of this time and age. Our recent experience with COVID-19 pandemic has also shown us that we must adapt to ever-evolving education technology, and that traditional teaching alone will not suffice. In my view, while the role of the principal is important to provide school leadership, it is the self-motivated, committed, and inspired teachers that make all the difference to the quality of education in a school. And therefore, ladies and gentlemen, I want to salute all the past and present teachers who are gathered here for their services and for their contribution to the life of thousands of students that have passed out of this school. I also want to share a few words with the students. Dear students, your school life is the most memorable part of your life, and it stays with you throughout your life. Make the best use of it. Curricular, co-curricular, extracurricular, all activities are important. They help you to develop a well-rounded personality. While discipline is important, it is equally important to develop a curious mind and the faculties of critical thinking that foster a spirit of inquiry. These traits, when nurtured in the right way, produce scientists, innovators, leaders, and agents of change. Therefore, you must cultivate, practice, and demand the freedom to criticize and dissent, not only within the school, but also in every sphere of your life. Healthy debate, discussions, and the habit of understanding the other's point of view in an accommodative spirit will take you far in life. Friends, in conclusion, I would like to once again congratulate the alumni, faculty members, and the student body of Don Bosco Higher Secondary School for their successful completion of 50 years. I have every reason to be confident that the people who administer the affairs of this institution will carry on the onerous task of delivering quality education, which is affordable, in the days to come and years, and will become a model of excellence in education for others to emulate and follow. With these very few words, I once again thank the organizers for giving me this opportunity to share some of my views with you and to convey my greetings to all of you on this very joyous occasion. Thank you. God bless. Jai Hind.